So if you
just, there.
If you just take the forever nap, you can only do that once.
Fuck, that's bullshit.
You're so right, Colin. Mm-hmm. I only came in on the latter half of that conversation, but I'm proud to say I agree.
Mm-hmm. Colin solved suicide.
Whoa.
We did it, Pat. We saved the city.
Yes.
Now it's time for some nice and pleasant downtime.
Ugh. I'm awake. I'm ready. Let's do this.
Hi, Caleb. Hi, Sinner.
Hi.
I chose death.
Mm-hmm. I don't know if you had much of a choice in that. You went in missing a health block.
God, dude, I I'll be honest, Colin. I was not expecting to die that quick. I thought I was gonna get something. I was like, no, that sounds about right. This is cool.
I mean,
God.
Look, you fucked with an angel. An angel who was put there for a purpose. Now, she had been chilling for a long time, too, but,
She was so nice to us!
She was! She was a so delight. Nice.
You guys like her a lot. Problems.
I'm not the problem! I'm dead!
Okay, that
I'm
makes
a very
it better.
Big problem, I can admit this.
I...
Look, as long as no more problems appear, things should be fine.
Man, wouldn't it be crazy if we fucking got the pressure up to 15?
That'd be so crazy, but like, here's the thing. I don't think anybody here right now could get the pressure up to 15. Like, one of you three getting the pressure up to 15 would be monumental. That one could probably get the pressure up to 15, though.
No!
I think we could get it up to 15 if we worked together.
There's the man.
I think if Zay could roll perfectly, I could get it up to 13.
Oh, well, maybe. Maybe.
We all roll perfectly.
What are you doing here?
Hi.
Hi, are you joining us on this downtime?
I am. I will be joining us for this downtime.
Aww.
That's not concerning at all.
What? It's just downtime, guys. It's just downtime.
Nothing's
gonna happen. Probably.
Yeah, do you have a problem? Do you have a problem with my underling? Yeah, is there a problem?
Hey, Colin.
No, I think Peter's a delight.
Underling? Underling?
Yeah, in the Golden Devils.
Not your underling.
I'm older.
I let you call me Cricket once, and all of a sudden I'm an underling.
Look.
Okay, we can be equals.
Oh God.
Yay, equality.
Mm-hmm.
Man, we're really gonna get the pressure up to 15.
I hope.
15.
What are you implying that we're going to be doing? What are you going to be doing?
I'm doing nothing.
Should I be worried about
you? I just exist here. No, it's all you.
Maybe
I'm not the problem.
Sheep's clothing.
No.
What have I ever done?
That's Marcus.
Surprisingly, Marcus has been quite tame recently.
We should make his hate like Damon early. He'd be like a little sheep.
Caleb has been the little problem child.
Yeah. That's true. Caleb does something and everyone else just starts fucking heaving and just going rabid.
Heaving?
I've done like two things. They just happen to be very bad things.
Back to back.
Not quite back to back. There was a session in... No, I'm lying. There wasn't a session in between. But this can be the session in between.
Yeah.
Between another one? So-
or you could double down or triple down.
Angel's trying to be on its best behavior. It's just not good at that.
Wait, hold up.
Hold up? Yeah.
Holding on.
Hello?
So in the announcements, I saw that someone had died.
Yeah,
some nobody.
Oh, okay. It said he was beheaded by an angel, not by angel. Okay.
No. Oh. No. The angel did not do that. The angel was named Hester.
Okay. No Hester relation was so nice. To Key, by the way. Just so everyone knows.
Mm-hmm. Shaking my head.
At least as far as Key knows. Who knows? Dang. Why did he get his head chopped off?
God, he didn't get it chopped off. He got his head stabbed through and ripped apart, then tossed off a mountain.
Ugh. Poor guy.
He didn't feel any pain.
Did not feel any pain.
It was
that's
a painless good. Death.
Damn, though. That really does, he will be missed.
Hey, the angels got that dog in them.
She did. She was like, hey, can you guys not fight? And they were like, oh, yeah, we're gonna fucking fight you. And she was
we're
like,
gonna fucking do it. You know what? Just because you said we wouldn't, we'll do it.
You didn't have to fight. You could have dropped your weapons. You were the first one who ran up to her and attacked.
I'm surprised you didn't wait a turn. I'll be honest. I was like, oh, shit, okay.
And then Akil ran up and attacked.
Akil was, yeah, he wasn't gonna hesitate.
And then Damien ran up and attacked. And then Varos ran up and attacked. And she waited to make sure, all right, all of you are attacking me. Now.
He did think about waiting, but then Varos was like, nah, I don't want to surrender. So I was like, all right then.
No retreat, no surrender.
So she was guarding that ice block?
Yeah.
The weapon in the ice block.
It was worth it.
And Varos said, no, I want that.
It was worth it.
His ghost mommy told him to get it.
Worth it.
Huh.
Yep, he said, mommy, I need to get this thing.
Mommy, bottle.
Mommy, uppies.
I mean, he basically did ask for uppies when she fucking revived him.
So...
Yeah,
What?
As long as you guys don't fuck around today, should be fine.
Ooh. Sorry, I just read the part that said, even Claudia's old master wouldn't have killed an angel. That is one of the most heinous acts according to the high gods. Oh, and you all got 2 level ups. Ooh.
Hey, Peter, you know that's like an every other Friday back where we're from.
I mean, we haven't killed any angels.
You haven't killed any angels.
No, I'm talking about something else.
I mean, yes.
We have been up to a lot of stuff.
All right, though. Are y'all ready to get underway for this downtime?
Ready to downtime.
Are
down
we? Are we?
Party, if not, you're here now. Buckle up and let's go. Keep all hands and legs inside the vehicles at all times. DM, take it away.
Ash. Falling from the sky. That's where we find most of you now. As it was in the night when the mountain exploded. When that horrific shearing of rock and fire cut through the night sky north of Bayo. All of you stood watching, waiting, listening. The Impure did not come from that direction despite being on guard all night. You don't know why the mountain was destroyed in a pillar of fire. But it was. It was like a hammer from the heavens being dropped with all the force that the rings could muster. And still, at 8 a.m. on the 24th of Lionier, ash still continues to fall from the sky. The brigade is on high alert. but the day is yours. All of you have time to do what you will. And I think those connected to the Venerable Hounds would have been aware that a few of your compatriots were not at camp last night and strolled in back to the brigade's camp early this morning, about 3 or 4 a.m. But what are you guys doing on your downtime?
Fun. Kalay. Ooh. Well, I know Key wants to track down talismans, since their time is running out.
Okay. Talisman, where are you?
Probably pacing back and forth in his tent.
Gotcha. Then, Key, as you make your way to the camp of the Venerable Hounds, you believe that Talisman is in his tent?
I'll go up. Knock, knock, Talisman. May I come in?
I think Talis will... He'll kind of, like, jump as though startled out of his thoughts. And then, upon seeing you, he'll just kind of lower his head a bit and step outside. We could talk out here.
Perfect. How about we talk while we walk? Also, like, having now seen Talis, does he notice anything? Like, is anything different or just same information I had before?
Same information you had before. Well, and of course the new information you've gotten, but, you know.
So that is public knowledge, like, to people in the brigade.
That, I mean, to you, that talisman is no longer connected to you in any way.
Okay, but I don't know what has happened, why that happened. I just know that happened.
Correct.
Okay.
Talisman, I don't believe, has informed the brigade in any substantive way of the deal.
Okay. just someone a little bit more private. After all, I think there's much for us to talk about.
But just let's keep it short.
Key will, like, cock an eyebrow and smile faintly. Of course. And then once we've gotten to somewhere a little bit more private, we'll carry conversation more so from there. So, Talis. I know that you and I are no longer connected as we once were. And I just want to make sure I know why.
Told me that I had a choice.
Care to explain?
Not particularly. But you said that I had 10 days to either take you up on your offer or figure out a different one. I figured out a different one.
I don't recall saying figure out a different one. I believe it was take me up on my offer in 10 days or enjoy those 10 days as you will. Now, it would take quite a lot to do what you have seemed to done. And I'm not quite willing to let it rest at you simply not telling me. After all, Talis, I'm sure we are more than friends at this point.
Talisman, please.
Talisman, of course.
I'm sorry, but I don't know what you're talking about.
He's like, smile will just, like, it's just gone. She's just deadpan. Talisman. My patience is running a little thin. That's not something that happens often, because in truth, I feel a bit slighted, a little bit disrespected, because you rejected me and my patron for something else. And I simply want to know what that was. What was the cost when all I asked was your friendship?
I asked the help of one of the Archfey. It took a toll on them, but they were willing.
Colin, can I do a spirit check to see if they're lying?
Sure, both of you make spirit checks.
Two successes.
That is one success for me.
It's hard to get a read on Talisman. You do not detect any insincerity.
Well, if that is indeed the case, I hope the toll was not too great.
I'm sure.
And I hope that you are able to live a happy, long life, Talisman.
Sure, the Archfey would not have agreed if the toll was too great. It might make things a little more difficult in the future, but...
Oh.
I believe they believed that the benefits outweighed the cost.
Of course. I will be keeping a very close eye on any extra difficulties that our camp comes across. After all, I want everyone here to be safe.
Of course.
Well, you can keep the flower. I'll be heading off now. If you need anything of me, don't. And Key will walk away.
Alright. And as Key walks away, Talisman, what are you feeling as you can see Key depart?
Incredible mix of dread and relief, because he is terrified to the bone of Key.
Fair enough.
And so I think he needs to just sit down on like a spare log for a second and breathe.
Fair.
And focus on not dying of a heart attack.
In that case, is you are going and sitting on a log. What is Zay up to this moment?
I think Zay would probably be taking over Akel's watch shift. Mm-hmm. And so he's probably just finishing off that, wanting to go have a conversation with Mace Crane.
Okay. Then, as you're finishing that up and you're walking through the camp, you see this hooded figure beckon you, Zay. Beckon you closer. Do you follow?
Oh, yeah, take a look to my left, take a look to my right, and, you know, I walk over.
As you walk over, you settle yourself in an area of camp that is strangely devoid of any civilians or soldiers. It's like this bubble where people are just naturally refusing to go. And the creature waiting for you is strange. Pale skin. Teeth that are jagged amongst like tightly stretched lips. White, milky eyes. Ratty hair. And the sulfurous smell, Zay. That smell that hangs in the air so thick. It's the devil that you met this last time.
You have sacrificed Zay.
That means a kill. It's not coming back.
Your blood brother spilt his blood to slay an angel. A grand sacrifice. A true sacrifice. Might I introduce myself? You may
please
call me Befrance, apothecary of the pale.
And this devil will give this ostentatious bow.
Can you say that one more time for me?
Befrance. B-I-F-R-O-N-S. Apothecary of the Pale.
What do you seek, young blood priest? Why do you tread our path?
It was when I was younger, this life I was brought to brought me clarity. I wish to share that with others, to have the choice to truly sacrifice themselves for something that they want to.
Then I can certainly offer you opportunity for sacrifice. Do you know why we spill blood? Why the sanguine flows from our nails and our blades and our teeth?
I wish to know more.
Good.
And with that, you find yourself plunging, Zay, plunging downward. You're falling and then splashing. You're sinking, Zay. Water all around you. What are you doing?
With my training, I kind of just at least get a bubble around my head.
And as you get that bubble around, you realize that this liquid is not water. You're sinking in an ocean of blood. The deep crimson spanning out in all directions.
And Zay will kind of just stop and try to just float there.
And you float, reaching an equilibrium in the blood until you're not sure which way is up and which way is down. You're just spinning inside the crimson.
Far below your dimension is the blood ocean. An entire world filled with blood. This blood is is protection. It is life. And it is running out. What lies beneath the blood ocean is beginning to drink. It has been drinking, Zay. Drinking for hundreds of years. Soon, this ocean of crimson will vanish. Its velvet perfection removed. And what lies beneath will rise. Unless we do our part. Unless we contribute to the greatest good. To protect this world. To give to the Blood Ocean. Me and my master were conscripted by those of your order to bring people like you into the fold. People who will spill enough blood to fill this ocean. And with that, you're back, Zay, standing amongst the tents. This is what you bleed for. This is the purpose. And if you continue, you will gain power and clarity and purpose. Let me ask, do you wish to rise higher? To begin your third trial. To enter the elite. Good. Very good. Hold out your left hand.
And without a second thought, Zay will hold out his left hand.
It's so quick. It's so painless. You almost don't think it's real, Zay, as your left hand is severed from your body. It does not bleed, though, that stump, as your hand falls to the ground. It's painful, but you don't let the blood drip. Blood is important. And then you watch this devil pull from their darkened robes a pale hand. They reach out towards you, Zay. And slowly, they attach that hand to yours. You feel this wave of energy, this connection, as the hand and the flesh, they bind. And then as you look down, that hand is your own, much paler than your own body, strangely enough. But you flex it back and forth, back and forth. This is the pale hand, Torvian. It will allow you to sacrifice bodies and their blood to the ocean. At least once you grow powerful enough. That power is close now, Zay. And Bifrons will take something else out of their cloak. A single chemist's vial, Zay, made out of gold. And they pass it over to you. And you can add this golden vial to your inventory.
You must fill this vial, Zay, with the blood of the most powerful being you can find. The more powerful, the better. Once you have this vial filled, you will return, and you will use this blood as a base for your own reaping power. Soon, you will reach high enough where, with our guidance, whole cities will be given to the blood ocean by your hand. Great power comes, say, but only if you can find power enough to fill the vial. When you have toiled and are done, call to me. I will return, and I will judge you, Zay. Do not disappoint me when I find you. And the devil leaves you. What are you doing?
Zay cracks his neck a little bit and just smiles towards the sky. And we'll move on with this day.
Okay. Bloom or Charon, what do you guys want to be doing?
I think you should go first.
Actually, Bloom would probably try to find Charon.
Okay. Lovely. Then you're trying to track down the book?
Yep.
Gotcha. Then if you're going to go and try and do that, you would probably have to go and talk to Zishan.
Oh, great. So great here.
Are you wanting All to right, do that?
Yeah, I want my buddy. Let's do this.
Okay. Then, as you go, going to find your buddy, you find Zishan inside their cabin, or rather, just outside of it, tending to plants about. And Zishan will smile as you approach. Hello there, Bloom.
Hi, Zishan. Could I borrow Charon for a bit?
Oh, of course. Do you have anything you wish to get off your chest? Anything at all.
Looking, they clearly know what happened, right?
Hard to say. They're a Zishan.
They are a Zishan. I think Bloom will kind of grit his teeth and say, there is something, the mountain last night that may have had to do with Varos and Damien and I, and Akel.
Yes. Why did you do it?
I panicked. I wanted to help Varos because he's helped me, and because the item he was looking for, I'd seen it in a vision, and I thought it could help me to figure out what was going on with those visions.
Yes, visions.
Yes.
What do you think about those visions?
They're scare me a lot, honestly. Most of them have been extremely unpleasant, and then I had one that actually seemed fine, and then I found out I was in a city that was on a ring that apparently got destroyed a few thousand years ago. And I don't really know what to make of any of it.
Oh, well, butterscotch candies are found in the most unlikely places.
I don't have a clue what that means.
That tends to be your life. Not knowing what anything means, bumbling around, touching things, breaking things, testing, trying, and doing everything that you can, except being patient.
But I would being patient really solve anything? I thought I was put here to make decisions on behalf of Bloom, but
is that your place?
I thought it was. I thought that was what I was here to do, but every decision I've made has made everything a whole lot worse.
This world has a funny thing about it. When you stop trying to force things to happen and start listening to the things around you, listening to the birds and the breeze and the worms beneath your feet, every now and then, you just might learn the right thing to do. You try and push for things. You try and mold this world because you think you have a right to it. I'm about to tell you the truest thing you've heard in a long time. The world does not revolve around you. That body does not revolve around you. You act like you are the most important person in this camp. There are thousands of people with lives. And you, Bloom, or whatever you are, go about acting like somehow your will, your wishes, supersede the rest. They do not! Listen to the world around. Let things come in time. Else I fear we might not have many mountains left. Besides, and he will kind of boop you on the nose, you've committed a divine sin. Redemption is beyond you now. Did you know that it takes the tiefling brain almost 6 seconds to recognize that it has been severed from the body? It is the longest delay of any humanoid creature besides the Gith Zerai. I've sometimes pondered that. Why it takes so long for the brain to realize that it's already dead. Maybe it's just not aware. Here's the book, and Zishan will give it to you. Take care of it.
I'll take care of Charon. I'm sorry, really. I'll take a step back. I know redemption is beyond me, but I won't make anything worse.
I hope not. Let's just start by being truthful. And Zishan will head back into their cabin.
I think Bloom would probably head back to the Venerable Hound's camp for now. And it would probably along the way, it would open Charon's book so they could talk.
Okay, then as you're heading back to the camp, Charon, you find your book has been opened.
What do you want now?
Well, I was going... I had planned on talking to Veruz and was going to see if you wanted to accompany me. Now I might just hang out in the camp, but... Thetian handed me the book, so I can close you again if you want.
Does something smell burnt to you?
Yeah, that would be the mountain. There's still a lot of ash.
Right. Anyway, you don't want to go see Veruz anymore, but you let me out anyway? Or you just need me as an excuse to go?
I mean, I don't plan on seeing him any longer. I figured I may as well let you out if I had you. I imagine it's... I prefer to be around and walking. I thought you might like the same. So I thought I'd release you anyway.
Oh. That's a nice thought. Thank you.
Yeah.
Do you know how I'm supposed to contact him? Am I just supposed to wait?
Veruz? I mean, I'll probably be... Looking around, do I see the staircase to the roost anywhere?
You mean you see it towards the edge of, like, the camp where it's parked. And you also see an unexpected visitor watching you.
Oh, motherfucker. Sorry, Angel is probably pointedly avoiding eye contact with Bob, and it'll just say, I mean, the roost is right over there if you wanted to go talk to him. I can accompany you. I just don't think I'm going to ask him what I was going to.
Yeah, that would be nice. Do I notice that something's up? That you look weird?
You feel something's up, yeah.
Do I see anything?
I think Bob wouldn't hide his presence from you. But in this moment, Talisman, what are you up to?
After calming down, he's going to go... I think he's going to go to Anahi's tent.
Gotcha. You would probably then find Anahi as she's resting after just having got finished working a shift at the medical tent, and she'll kind of look over to you and smile. Oh, man, it's been a long few days, huh?
You don't even know. Mind if I come in?
Yeah, I think we have some things to talk about.
Do you terribly mind if I go first?
No.
Okay, because there's a lot going on, and I know I said that I'd tell you later, and it is now later.
Yeah.
Please, please, please don't freak out until the end, okay?
I promise just... to have the appropriate reaction.
Can you have an inappropriate reaction to the calmer side?
I'll do what I can. Please tell me you have not continued dabbling in that black magic.
A few days ago, I was... It's a long story, so just bear with me till the end, okay? A few days ago, we were on a mission, as you know. On this mission, it was the one where we found Thomas's son. I ended up... We were ambushed by Impure. And I ended up being wounded very severely. I met someone. I think it might have been Death. While we were walking together somewhere, though, there was a voice that asked me if I wanted to keep on living. And I said yes. I mean, anybody would. Have you seen that weird person around camp with the long dark hair? Kilos?
The one with the wings?
Have I... Oh yeah, I noticed Key having wings, right?
Yes.
Yes, that one. She was with us on the mission, and she had contacted her patron to resurrect me.
Well, that's good.
No.
Wait, so you died?
Yes.
But Key saved you?
Yes. Story what? Doesn't end there.
Oh, okay.
I went back with Key, listened to her speech. I had... The saving was temporary. I had 10 days until I had to go on a mission with her. She wasn't clear on the specifics, but it was some kind of ritual. Essentially, I would have to abandon Grania and swear, and I'm quoting, my undying loyalty to Key and her patron. Which is not a great deal. When I learned about that, and I couldn't speak the terms of the deal to anyone either, I wasn't able to. When that happened, I ended up writing this, just in case I did end up, you know, dying. And he'll kind of awkwardly toss the letter onto her desk. Don't worry about reading it now. But that's why some of the writing in there is so stilted. I couldn't speak specifics. But I was trying to figure out a different way to, you know, keep being alive, keep serving. And I ran into someone.
Okay.
I had first tried talking to the Archfey. They were able to help in theory, but it would be like a partial life at best. Completely soulless, almost like a puppet.
That doesn't sound like the Archfey.
Not a puppet in like... Not on purpose, at least. Their power was limited. I couldn't... It's hard to describe. They weren't being nefarious. They were just being honest that they didn't have the power to return me completely as I am now. I went for a walk to think my options over. And I ran into someone who claimed to be able to help. We talked for a bit. It turns out that he is a devil named Bob.
Tell us. What did you do?
Didn't like any of the terms he was offering, and I don't want to make a deal with the devil, so I tried walking away. And he said that if I walked away without making a deal, he would come find you. And he said that if he told you I had died, he felt confident that he would be able to manipulate you into a deal.
Did you have such little faith in me?
No. But I was more worried of the chance that he was right. These things are persuasive.
Yes, they're devils. They have forked tongues. They lie from birth.
I know. So I stayed and made a deal. I'm alive for now. Wanted misery, which is, of course, difficult to stomach. But he wanted supplies when we attempted to move camp.
How much supplies?
I don't know how to phrase in character our specific deal.
Tons.
A good amount. Enough to make the morale of the camp drop a bit and feed his desire for misery.
What are the tenets of our goddess?
Sorry.
What are the tenets, initiate?
Out of character, I don't believe I have those, but would Talisman know?
If you don't know out of character, you don't know in character. Because you know what Karania is about, I hope.
I do. I just wasn't sure if there was specific wording that I needed to have.
No.
The collective action. Community.
What does that mean?
Care of one another.
She full-on backhands you with all the strength she's got.
And then you take what we have been trying to give to these people. Our faith is about building community. Our goddess preaches the building of cities, towns. We are her hands. And you've just told me that you've been dabbling in dark magic, and in this dabbling of magic to bring yourself back, you turn the cost upon the people who our goddess has told us to protect? How dare you? I can't. How do we stop this? How does this end?
Doesn't end well.
What do you mean it doesn't end well? Surely there is a way to stop this.
That I know of.
Make a spirit check.
That's not good. That's no successes.
Anahi will look you in the eyes. And it feels like she's looking into your soul, Talus. And in this moment, she knows you're lying to her. And that might be the worst part. As she just takes this half step back, all our lessons, everything. What was it for? If you have nothing else to say, you can go.
Alice will leave.
And as you head out, what are you doing, Talus?
Going the long way back to his tent.
Okay. Then as you begin to take the long way back, Key, what are you doing?
Key would actually be looking for Bloom.
Okay. Then I think at this moment, you would see Bloom and Charon walking about.
Ah, hello there. He will wave a big hand.
Oh, hey, he, right?
Yes, yes, he. And, Bloom and Charon, right?
Right.
Absolutely. I'm Perfect. Hurt at the hesitation, but...
Oh, I mean... Many faces, many names. I still got there in the end.
That's more than I can say for most people.
Oh. Now, you two are just the right people to ask this question. So I think you'll be honest with me.
Okay. What's the question?
Do I make people afraid?
Are you asking the skin book?
Yes.
I don't know if I'm really an authority on that. You don't make me afraid, but I mean.
And to that, he will have a bright, genuine smile. Thank you. And Bloom, what about you?
Yes, I haven't really paid much attention to others' reactions to you. I found you... I mean, you were helpful and friendly on our mission, although... Well, the event you had with Talisman was certainly jarring.
See, and that is why I especially like you, Bloom. You're honest and kind. Now, like you said, though, I have been helpful. I have been kind. Yet,
It seems some people don't appreciate that. Why?
Could you be a little bit more specific?
Yeah, who's... Is someone... like... bothering you? Because I'll... I wouldn't do anything, but... you should tell us.
I appreciate the thought. Yes, no, I mean... bothering me... yes, in a way. Talisman. I helped Talisman. You were there. You saw. They only had to do one little thing for me. Which was simply be my friend. And yet, they chose other paths. Other paths that had more of a cost on others. Instead of simply being my friend, and I'm having a rather hard time wrapping my head around that. Isn't that how it works? You know, help people, people like you, they help you back. That's how it works, isn't it? And here you can see that he is kind of like... that like calm, confident demeanor that he always has has shifted a bit. This is shaking key.
I feel like I'm missing a little bit of context, but no, I'm missing a lot of context. Key, could you... I don't even know... were you guys on a mission together? Something happened, or...?
Yes, no. I believe... weren't you there, Aaron? Holding the back? If I recall... perhaps not. My memory is getting a little bit more jumbled lately. At any rate, yes, Talisman died. I brought him back. And all he had to do was a little thing to make it permanent and be my friend. That's how you make friends, isn't it? You help them, right? That's how you make friends. You're helpful. You're useful. Right?
That's generally how you make friends, but I think everyone has their limits. Guy was a good friend to me, but I was too afraid to go on his rescue mission for him. I couldn't help him there.
Well, you know, the... both parties have to agree that it's helping. I mean, maybe it just... I don't know, wasn't what he needed, or... Caron's takes, like, a little step back. Just a little bit, but... I don't know. Yes, I would say that helping each other is a very friendly thing to do. But, you know, there's other things. Offering help? Well, I guess you couldn't offer in that...
Oh, I did. Talisman knew and accepted and took my hand. He chose me over death, and then he chose something else over me. You know, I think I'm figuring it out. I thought, coming in here, everyone could be my friend if I only was helpful. But I think not everyone deserves to be my friend. Don't you agree?
I mean, I think you would have a point in saying that it is impossible to be friends with everyone.
Yes. I'll make sure to be much more selective from now on. But you two must not fret. You two are assuredly my friends.
Well, I sure hope so. We share the same camp.
Now, tell me, what is the one thing you desire most in the whole world?
I don't like this.
I think what I desire most is beyond reach right now.
Maybe, maybe not. But telling me, could it hurt?
Situation is, yes, there's a lot right now.
Yes, with ash falling from the sky, a mountain simply wiped from the map. Quite a lot of things are happening. Big things. Do you happen to know why?
I do. The mountain was the fault of a few friends and I, which is part of why I'm hesitant in trying to pursue what I want further. It seems like that has not worked out so far.
He will gesture to hold Bloom's hand.
I mean, he'll allow it.
And that's okay. Things happen. People make mistakes. But what's important is that you learn from it. You grow. But never give up on the thing you want most. But, if you wish not to tell me, I understand. All things in good time. But Charon, do you wish to share, or are we not quite there yet?
Charon is sweating. And looks very pale, or gray, I guess. Maybe we could talk about it later. I have to think, you know, if it's like the one thing I want the most in the world, you know, I need some time.
Understandable. But know that I, as your friend, will help you in whatever way I can, with reason, of course. I'm learning that the hard way. But I'm here to listen and to help where I can. And that is a genuine smile from Key's face to you, Charon. Something of reassurance.
I shakily grin with my sharp, shaved teeth. Yes. Of course.
Well, where was it that you two were off to? Just curious.
We were off to go talk to a friend.
Well, I could use the fresh air if you would like the company, but again, I understand. I can be off elsewhere.
I think Bloom's just gonna kind of look towards Charon.
Maybe we could hang out after. It was a scheduled thing.
Oh, of course, of course. How about we stargaze?
Make a spirit check, Key.
That is 2 successes.
Charon, make a spirit check.
Oh, balls. I'm... Oh, we have the same score. Dope. One success.
Jesus. Key. Something is off in Charon's tone of voice. You're not sure if this was scheduled beforehand, and bad thoughts are starting to creep into your head.
Charon.
Yes.
I'll ask you one more time. Are you afraid of me?
Of you? No, it's just, no, I'm just, you know, something you said just reminded me of, someone. I'm just a bit shaken, it's okay. But it's not you.
Well, I apologize. I will try to watch my words more closely next time so as to not bring up bad memory.
It's very kind of you. Thank you.
Of course. I'm here for you. Now.
I am here for you as well, Cricket.
Key will smile. Now. I will let you carry on with your... and he will air quotes, scheduled meeting with your friend. I hope you two have a great day, and perhaps, if you are free, we could do a bit of stargazing.
Ooh, I read a lot about them.
Yes, and I would be delighted to just give you a tour.
Stargazing sounds quite nice, actually.
Perfect. Then perhaps we'll see each other later tonight, and the skies will be clear. Ta-ta. And Key will saunter away, feeling a lot better now that she's vented to her closest friends.
Fair enough. Charon and Bloom. As Key walks away, what are you two doing?
I don't like the idea of her and Faru's meeting. I don't know that would go well.
No. No, I don't think so.
I
Yeah.
It's fine. Let's go talk to the man, perhaps. Maybe he can make my day worse.
We don't have to go if you don't want to.
I don't know. He might be able to tell me something, anything, about myself, about him, about what the fuck I'm supposed to be doing, anything.
Understand that.
So then are you two heading towards the staircase?
Yeah.
Yeah, as we're going, can I try and do a little bit of what Zishan said? Just kind of paying attention to what's around me?
Yeah. And as you're going up and just paying attention, you would see high up above camp, he is just watching you head towards the staircase. As you peek around some more, you can see that there are strange flurries in the ash. You feel tremors in the ground from far off. There are so many hidden details in this camp. All you had to do was listen to it. And it's just strange how in tune with this place you can get.
The strange flurries in the ash, do those seem similar to the snow flurries on the mountain that were, like, weird and, like, going in reverse?
There are similarities.
Okay.
But as you two are walking, Zay, what do you have going on, buddy?
Oh man, I would still like to go see my man, Mace Crane.
You know what? That is so fair. And as you head that way, you would find Mace Crane kind of in one of his tents. Actually, wouldn't be in his tent. He would probably be with Cordell at this time, kind of in an office just adjacent to hers in the cabin. But he would be more than happy to welcome you in.
Ah. Zay, is it?
Indeed.
Sit down.
I will take a seat.
Could I interest you in some wine?
I'll partake in this.
And he will pour out a glass of red wine for you and a glass for himself, and he'll kind of cheers with you and take a sip.
Why have you found your way in here?
Mostly just checking up on you, seeing if you need anything, and letting you know I was going to be going on Buried Bane and wonder if you need anything while we were over there.
Well,
and you can see Mace thinks for a moment.
Mostly, what I require is the treasure within. It is important for the war effort. Simple as that. Getting it the sooner the better will yield best results. Especially with the magics that have been thrust upon this ring as of late. A whole mountain disintegrated. The Archfey are up in arms. The people are scared. Why shouldn't they be? Tell me, what do you think of me?
A man that is willing to do what he needs to, even if it's not the right.
I see then.
Or if I could say, you know, the kindest thing.
You think me a hard man. I understand. Our first meeting would likely have given you this impression.
Yes.
Bothering for the safety of me and my people. People that I have taken under my wing. This I will not compromise with. But there is necessity in benevolence to safeguard those around us. It's a good thing. The numbers, they do not care. They are what they are. I try and add meaning to the numbers where I can. Do anything? No. We'll be honest. I didn't think all of you would fall for the bluff. But here we are. And in the future, I will not be able to bluff. I might have to be that hard man. But if there are ways out, if I can assemble the right allies, we might not be forced into those hard decisions. There are devils about this camp, Zay. I'm not sure if you know. It feels like vultures are coming next to an animal about ready to die in the desert. I do not intend to be one of those animals.
Neither do I.
It's a civilization, then. And he'll raise his glass.
Civilization.
And he'll drink.
I do have a question.
It will answer if I can.
Given our current circumstances, when do you think we should start moving camp?
Soon. Although, no squads as of yet have found a way through the mountains. With the explosion, though, our scouts say the Impure are beginning to rally, picking up the pace, smelling blood. If we cannot find a way through the northern mountains, we will have to fight our way out and make our way across the western road. Even then, I expect we have another 2-3 days before they fall upon us. Battle will be here soon.
Well, I'll be doing my part to get this mission underway, and hopefully then we can get a scouting party to the pass, or to hopefully find the pass. Then we go from there.
As soon as the pass is found, then I would advise moving.
Understood. I'll start passing the word around, trying to make it top priority.
If we can just find that way through, we can navigate, get these people to safety, begin the arduous trek towards Widowstone.
They've talked about.
Yeah. Our deaths are likely. Throwing them away stupidly. That's something I wish to avoid. I still have scores to settle. Debts to pay.
Yes. I don't want to die in a meaningless fashion.
So much of death is meaningless. I fear it might be hard to avoid.
It comes eventually, but I just hope it brings meaning when I die to others.
I can drink to that. And he will take another sip from his wine.
Well then, thanks for the talk.
Thank you for the company. Keep me posted about what happens in camp, how the people are feeling, what the enemy is up to. I will do what I can. So far, you've done well.
Understood. I'm actually going over to the medical tents right now. Hopefully bring some joy to them.
You see the thinnest smile kind of peek out from Mace Crane's face. Before you go, then, you should probably not be eating this. Too many pounds, anyway. And he will pull out what appears to be like a small bar of chocolate, and he'll toss it over to you. Help me keep my cholesterol down.
That I can do.
Good. And he'll turn back to his work.
And on my way out, I'll wave to Cordell.
And you can see Cordell is looking over so many like files and pieces of paper. She seems tired, and she'll just kind of frown. You must have a job. Get back to work.
On it. Going to go support the people in the medical tent.
Don't tell me. Just do it.
Yes, Cordell.
She'll just keep her head down and continue filling out funeral arrangement forms.
Zay will leave the building.
Okay. Then as Zay leaves the building, Talisman, what are you doing?
Thinking.
Gotcha. You would just like to be thinking?
Despairing, even.
Oh, lovely. In that case, you probably attract a friend.
No, I didn't mean that. Never mind.
How goes it, Talis?
Leave.
Oh. Why? Are we not on speaking terms?
Would a please convince you?
At one point, possibly. Now, unlikely.
What do you want, then?
I'm just here to chat. To see if you need anything.
Nope.
Your conversation with Anahi, it did not go over well. Would you like a redo?
What do you mean?
You head back and have the conversation again. Like the first one didn't happen.
Absolutely not.
Why? It could go better for you.
because that's... No, I will not be doing that.
Come now, Talis. In for a copper, in for a gold.
No, thank you.
Then what will you be doing? Simply moping here in your tent?
Ignoring you, first of all.
You're doing a rather poor job of it.
Second is drafting a plan on how to help the current state of the brigade.
And what is the current state of this brigade?
I think that you are aware.
You might be moving soon, and I'm not sure if you have enough for our bargain.
We'll get there.
And what if you don't?
We will. And if we don't, what happens, happens. Not like I have control over it. I can only have control over our readiness.
Would you like control, then?
I'm sorry?
Well, I know many things, Talisman. I might be able to get you exactly what you need.
I'm not interested in making further deals.
I know where the Impure lie. Any of the lieutenants, any of their infamous. Ask for a name. I can provide it to you. You can go and you can kill one of their most powerful. You could have the hearts of all your people soar. Take their supplies. Take their intelligence.
Only for you to take it.
Everything has a cost. But you know that.
We'll make that deal with someone else. I do not need it.
We'll see. And Bob will leave. And will you continue to think?
Yes.
Okay. Then at this point, we find Bloom and Charon at the base of the stairs. You heading up?
Forgot I was muted. Yes.
Angel will follow after Charon.
Gotcha. Then, as you go and you follow after Charon, you can make your way up into the roost, where you would find one Veruz waiting, looking over books, just generally relaxing. You can see Kuno in a room farther down the hallway, dusting, sweeping, generally, you know, keeping to himself. Charon. Hello.
Good afternoon. Good afternoon.
Close enough. Hard to tell. I believe it's about 2:00.
I give a wave to Kuno and I'll head further in.
Kuno will give an energetic wave back.
Angel will also just give a little wave to acknowledge Kuno.
And Kuno will give the same wave. Am I to assume that we have much to do today between the three of us?
I think I'll hold back on what we've been doing. I just came to accompany Charon.
Very well. So then, what did you hope for, Charon?
I
if I'm honest, it would be... I want to remember what I forgot. There's a chunk in my memory that's gone, and I don't know what I did. I don't know why this happened. But if that's too much to ask, maybe information on my, I don't know what to call him. Creator.
Nicholas Black, you mean?
That's the one.
Also known as the Banker of Bones. A powerful beast.
Yeah.
A warper of the flesh. Something of a jester of a more macabre kind. He delights in the experimentation of what the body and mind can endure. His creations are nefarious, to be sure. Not that I'm saying you are nefarious.
To Charon grins a little bit.
However, Nicholas Black rarely ever does something without purpose. Whether that purpose is just fun or something else, that is to be examined. You have quite a history from what I can gather, Charon. But if you could you relay what you know about yourself?
How much? Just...
whatever you know.
I am from the Dark Ring. I had a family. I read a lot as a kid. I liked storytelling. I tried to learn a lot. When I was young, the Aether Eater calamity came to, I guess, my town, my village. And I was trapped under the rubble of a building. My leg was pinned and I couldn't move. And the maiden, I told you about her, she saved me that day. She carried me to safety. I suppose I grew up after that. And I don't know. I woke up, I was pulled into this world different and wrong, and it hurt.
I see. The moment of your creation, it is unclear, then.
I don't know. I don't know anything about it, I don't think. I was... I guess I don't know what my last memory was, but there was a long time, and... gosh, maybe... what, I'm in my... early adulthood, maybe
20s. And that was about, I don't know, 380 years ago? Something like that. 400.
I see. That was the point in your creation, to the best of your recollection.
Yes.
Fascinating. In this case, before I go exploring what might lie within your mind, I will need to check your pages to make sure that what Nicholas Black has left will not do either of us any harm.
Luma.
Yeah. And he'll hand it over, the book.
Thank you. I can't pick it up. Do my hands go through it, or do I just can't lift it?
Your hands just go through it.
I'll kind of demonstrate.
Certainly one of Nicholas Black's tricks. In this case, we should probably go to a more secure room. Bloom, may you please grab the book and follow me.
Yeah. And Bloom will grab the book and follow.
Okay. Then, as you go, Firouz will lead you deeper down the hallway. And eventually, you enter this pristine-looking room filled with marble flooring. This pale blue light covers the space and douses everything in this kind of bluish hue. And as this happens, Firouz begins to pull from a series of chests in one corner of the room materials. You can see he begins to pull what appears to be some candles, some salt, or something that looks like salt flakes, along with other gemstones, and begins to array them in a series of concentric overlapping circles. What I am now doing is arranging these circles of protection. They should offer us many layers of defense in case anything begins to emerge from your pages, other than you, that is, Charon.
Does this look like the same circles Margot set up for me?
No. No, 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 no. This is far more intricate.
Ah, gotcha.
Like, if Margot was, like, a teenager just learning to drive, this guy's a NASCAR driver.
Gotcha, I see.
He kind of finishes it up. Bloom, would you be waiting just inside this room near the door? If things go terribly wrong, then I would ask you to go and fetch help as quickly as you can.
Am I going to hurt you?
Likely.
I'm sorry.
Would I get one of the Archfey?
Oh, the Archfey. Oh. We cannot be too careful.
Are you sure? Maybe if I'll hurt you, is it worth it?
Do you wish to know more about yourself?
I...
At the very least, learning what is within the pages of your book, it could be a great boon.
Okay. Well, Bloomer.
Yeah.
Will you take my scythe?
I'll
just pull out like a small
rod that's kind of collapsible. It's pretty good, so. I give you permission to whack me.
Where did you get that?
Do I know where I got it? I don't know.
No, you do not.
No, I just have it. Kind of fits the ensemble.
It does. Keep that close then, Bloom.
Yeah, Bloom will go ahead and take the scythe and move over by the door where he was directed.
Feruz is going to begin to whisper a few incantations as sparks begin to arise from the series of circles. I am beginning to raise the wards now. Once they are complete, I will begin to place your book within the center of the circle. And you watch as, at this point, Charon, those sparks become fires of all different colors, interweaving amongst the circles. You smell something very sharp and pungent, almost like cinnamon in the air. As the smell begins to spread, Veruz begins to draw these arcane sigils in the air in front of him before he releases them. As all of these images begin to float in the air in languages that you don't understand, Charon, you watch as this ancient mage picks up the book and walks it to the center of the circle. With each step he takes, he gingerly looks around, almost like he's expecting something to happen, before eventually he sets the book down in the center, begins to arc the flames up into the air as they spiral down towards the pages. You watch as the flames simply begin to slide into the flesh of the book. And Veruz blinks once or twice. I see. We are not being stopped from translating. I'm also able to detect no defensive wards. Very strange. Bloom, stay near the door.
Yeah, you got it.
And Veruz is going to begin to make his way back into the circle. And he will begin to open the book. You're able to see Charon from far away as Veruz's eyes take on a golden tint as the writing within the book also begins to glow. This strange golden hue as Veruz seems to be reading with lots of care. Fascinating. Yes, I believe this is a grimoire of sorts. There are histories within, spells, incantations, and more. Your soul, it is trapped here, bound within, but this book, it has so many twists and turns within the magic. And Charon, you begin to see sweat appear upon the brow of Veruz as he's about a fourth of the way through. This is strange. Charon, what powers do you possess?
I can perform quick curses. I can become a better version of myself. I can do illusory magic.
Illusory magic.
I can eat souls.
This goes so far beyond illusions. What about your ability to rewrite? Have you made use of this? And if so, when?
Rewrite?
Yes. And he's beginning to flip through the book faster now. Your touch. Nay, perhaps even your voice. Allows you to rewrite the words within objects. And people. No, it's more than that. There's a message within this book. Hidden within and conveyed through you. A message constantly emerging, swirling, attacking. Broadcasting from you at every moment of the day. Towards everyone close. Into every person, into every page. It likely has already infected the entirety of the brigade. Maybe it got off to Prez. No. This is... And he'll look up at you, Charon. I looked at your file. You fought Fane, the web dancer.
Yes.
That shouldn't have been possible. Fane was a being thousands of years old with powers to rival saints. How did your group, in their pathetic form, defeat her unless... Oh my gods. And he will begin to, like, flip through the pages more and more and more and examine them more closely. This message, did you know anything about it?
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
What is the message that you are saying? What are you doing to this world?
I don't know.
What do you mean, you don't know?
What am I doing?
A message not created by you. In these pages, the craftsmanship, yet the power within. You were Nyx, but yet mortal flesh. The power of these incantations. The preciseness. The subtlety. The power. It shouldn't be possible. It. Oh my gods. No. This shouldn't be possible. It's not all you. How did he do this? There's no way. He should have been. And you can see Veruz goes pale. Charon. And you can see his hands are beginning to shake as he pulls them back from the book. This is an abomination. No. It's worse than that. It's apocalyptic. Magic bent in ways that ought not be possible. And you watch as Veruz is gonna begin to pull a knife from his belt.
No.
Well, hey, can you tell us what's going on first?
I should destroy it. If I do, then maybe I can stop this before it spreads. And you can see Veruz is going to heft the knife in the air.
It didn't work last time!
What do you mean it didn't work last time?
I was stabbed once before, it didn't work!
The book? Stabbed?
Yes! Yes!
How? How is that possible?
I don't know.
Then
Sorry.
After Fane, the Nicholas, he was there, and my friend tried to convince him to let the others run, and he did, and she stabbed me.
Oh no. Maybe that's what he wanted.
He wanted...
Maybe it's too late. So much is already being rewritten. Maybe. Maybe I have to. And he'll flip the dagger around and bring it to his own throat.
No, 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 no.
This. If I... Staying in this terrible world. No. But then, damn! If I remain, I am trapped. But if I go, what happens to this poor soul of mine? Perhaps it is too late. And he'll snap his fingers, and you watch as all the fire dies away, as he will slowly close the book. And he'll put the knife down, just throwing it against the wall. This book must be undone, no matter the cost. It cannot be allowed to persist. If it does, then I quite frankly don't know. And he will stand up and look to you, Charon. And you know nothing about what is within.
Charon is openly weeping.
You watch as, at this point, Varus will make his way over, and he will take a handkerchief out of his pocket. He will offer it to you.
He takes it. I'm sorry. I don't know.
I know you do not. But our mission is now clear, Charon. Whatever force holds this book together, whatever keeps it bound, it must be destroyed. For the good of all people, it cannot be allowed to remain. Its presence. Its presence is beyond what I even thought possible. What Nicholas Black has done. I don't know how it was accomplished. I don't know how many years it took him. The trials, the experimentation. Yes, this is a masterpiece of soul binding, but it's more than that. It's perfect down to every fitting of the page, every rune carved into the flesh and in the paper. It is a masterwork. One could work upon this book for 100 years and still not make it as perfect as what is here now. I dare say, my friend, the most powerful, nay, the most dangerous thing on this ring might not be Nicholas Black, or Althara, or her impure. No. It might just be you. We hold within our hands the lives, the dreams, the existence of millions. We hold now their fates and their lives. You have been made a shepherd of this power, even though you do not understand it. And I am sorry that it is a burden that you now bear. But it is now my responsibility to aid you in this trial. Trial makes it seem like it is a challenge meant to be overcome. This is destiny. This is something woven deep into our fabric. That to pull out is to shake the very thing that makes us. I must prepare a ritual to learn where we must travel next. But now, Charon, we are engaged in the most important race of our lives. We race war itself upon a great stage of doom and desecration. Our limbs must stem the tide, else we shall know the fate of failed heroes and broken villains. In this great dance of angels and devils, I fear we are at center stage. And he will gently kind of mull the book over in his hands and pass it over to you, Bloom.
Bloom will kind of hesitantly take it.
You must not let any harm come to this book.
I won't.
I will call upon you soon. Once I know more.
Right. We'll come when you call.
Yes. I will. We will.
Take care and take heed.
Thank you.
Don't think
I'm sorry.
And do not apologize. This is beyond that.
Take care, Ferris.
And he'll just nod. I must begin my research. I have confidence you can see yourselves out. And Veruz will leave you. He stalks deeper in to his sphere.
Did you still want to stargaze with Key later, or do you want me to take you back to Zishin? Carol? I suppose for now, Bloom will just walk out of the roost with the book.
Okay. As you walk out of the roost at this moment, Key, are you still above?
Yes. I wanted to keep a close eye, make sure that they were okay.
Gotcha. Then, as you are above and stars are beginning to come out, you feel a tiredness begin to set in. An exhaustion, rather. And in this moment, as you're feeling this, you hear a voice kind of creep up to you. Your body
It undergoes so much strain. The people around you, they wear faces that change, like the flickering of a firefly. Be careful, Key. Will you respond?
Yeah, I really don't know how to respond to that.
Fair.
Key is making note of it, though. Like, actually taking that to heart. Definitely a lot for Key today.
Do not pay it mind, though. Complete your great deeds. Show the power that you have. Show the goodness. Show them what you can do. Yes, there are many dark hearts near you, my dear. It is their nature to have their blades find flesh. It does not matter to them if you are good or evil. Just that you are flesh. But with great deeds, your flesh can be protected. But you must always remember, Key, to many here, you are just flesh. They do not understand the concept of a friend. You feel the voice begin to move out and away. At this point, you are seeing below you Bloom and a closed book moving out of that sphere in the staircase.
You said that nightfall is coming soon, right?
Yes.
Okay. Once they've gone a little ways from the staircase and the sphere, Key would make her way down to greet them.
Okay. Then, Bloom, you see Key descend.
Key. Hello again.
Hello, Bloom. Did everything go well with your friend?
It was interesting. I think Charon had a bit of a more taxing time of it than I did, so I was going to drop her back off with Zishin, but if you would still like to stargaze after, I would like that.
And is Charon back in the book or still out?
I believe Colin said at the moment the book was closed.
Mm-hmm. Okay, gotcha. Understood.
Actually, perhaps it would be best to postpone for now. Little tired.
That's fine. Another time, then.
Yes. Perhaps tomorrow night. And give Zishin my regards, of course.
I will.
And he will make her way towards Margot's tent.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then you make your way there. Margot is inside the tent at the moment. You can see she is organizing things and will look up as you get closer. Key?
How was your day, Margot?
Eventful.
Would you like to tell me all about it? I'd be happy to listen.
Yes, I'm sure. Tell me about your day first.
Huh. Well, I had someone who could have been my friend that I helped. And yet they chose something other than me. Chose to have more burden. Put the cost on someone else rather than just simply be my friend. And I must say, it was a good lesson. I've learned a lot.
What a fascinatingly wrong lesson.
Key would look up at Margot with confusion marked on her face.
You think because someone wanted to bear a burden themselves on their own terms, that they are not your friend?
Well, when all I asked was to be my friend, and they decided to do something that would rather harm another person rather than simply be my friend, I think the message is a little clear.
Do you know what my profession is? Key.
Well, from what I know, before you were here in the camp, you were in a hospital, so I can only assume a healer.
I was an exorcist. I worked for Knaston, actually. It was my job to journey about the area around Tiprez and even beyond. And I would help those troubled by dark forces. Once I came upon an old satyr. She was possessed by a spirit that thought they were benevolent. This spirit argued that they were keeping the woman alive, that everything they were doing was strengthening the woman, and they could not possibly understand why the woman did not want them in their body. They argued that without them, the woman would die. But that wasn't the point. The woman wanted the choice. That's always what it boils down to in the end. The choice. Whether you can take that burden.
this life. It is fickle and it is finite. To take the responsibility of living it away from someone else, I've always found it disgusting. To have your friendship be tied to your control. That's not friendship, Key.
Well, I'll keep that in mind. For now, then, perhaps a small gift. Can you guess what animal it is this time?
Is it a bird?
Close. It's a bat. And he will produce what... Bird or bat is indistinguishable. You cannot tell exactly what this is. Mm-hmm. Still working on it.
Gotcha. And Margot will take it and smile. Thank you. I appreciate it.
Margot.
Yes, Key.
If everything goes well with the brigade, where do you hope to do after?
I don't let myself think that far. What about you?
Could I do a spirit save for this, actually?
Sure.
Nice. And detriment. I'm going to do it. Yeah, detriment one. Okay. Yeah, it's greater than three. That is two successes. Okay. I think that is enough for this answer. Yeah. My father. He's missing. Both of them, actually. I just want them home.
That's certainly something noble. And it's likely something you can't do alone.
That's why I need all the friends I can get.
And you can see Margot will place a hand on yours. Then you have to learn how to make them.
Thought I was.
Who taught you how to make friends?
No one really. Didn't exactly have much of a social childhood. I only had one friend, and they're gone now.
Well, if you allow me to meet the real Key, I'd like to start getting to know her.
Key will, like, hesitate for a moment and then de-transform.
There we go. Would
you like to play some cards?
I would like that. Yes.
Then, as Margo will begin to deal you some cards, I think it is here where we will end this downtime for today.
Whoa.
So much done, guys.
That was eventful.
Certainly was.
With your help, we can turn Charon into a cosmic stack level threat. Please donate your soul.
Let's fucking do it. Let's fucking do it. I'm so down. What do we gotta do?
We can do this. A group effort. I believe in us.
Fuck everything else. Fuck the banker. Fuck everything.
Genuinely, that is so heavy.
I just sent it to Damien. I just sent it to him. I'm so excited for his reaction. I said, you will not believe what Charon just got told. And he said, no, God, what happened?
Seriously, you keep getting handed these, like, very powerful stuff.
Well, smiling. Smiling through the pain. Hey, Colin. Mm-hmm. So that's why he wanted me to read it? Huh? Huh, buddy? You stupid bitch.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I'm going to kill you. We have to get Charon away from... We have to take him away. We have to put him in the ocean. We have to bury it in the ocean.
What does that even mean, rewriting everything? God damn.
I'm an ocean. Lightner.
You want to go to an ocean?
I would fill it. With the snap of my fingers.
So true.
Well, we just... Okay, look, listen. We just get a bunch of water and we pour it in there and then we get like a Jesus character to turn... Oh, I guess it's not water into blood. It's water into wine, isn't it?
Yeah, yeah.
Mm-hmm. I think Miss Crane would like
blood into wine.
I mean,
his blood
is
wine.
There was that one time, though, with the Egyptian plagues where he turned the river into blood.
That was a Jesus. That wasn't
Jesus. He said Egyptian.
Theoretically speaking, you can do water into wine and then do the Catholic thing of wine into blood.
With the transubstantiation. That is so accurate.
I'm just stab a hoe.
It won't look like blood, but it will metaphysically. Metaphysically, yeah.
How about I just like double down and just murder people at night?
You know what? I love this, and I'm really curious whose blood you take. That's gonna be cool.
Yeah.
Only if the pure weren't fucks.
Open ended for you. Whenever you find a character and you're like, all right, this is the blood I'll take. And the more powerful the character's blood you get, the better the reward.
Oh, man.
Walk up to one of the archfiends.
Get the fuck away from me.
I was honestly thinking, oh, Trip, sorry.
You don't know anything. You weren't
oopsie
there.
Oopsie doopsie,
thank
anything.
You.
You don't know anything. You don't
sorry
know
anything. Sorry I fell on you with my knife. Don't worry
Can
about
I
this vial.
Do I bleed?
God, Zane will be right there, waiting for you.
Right?
There's a lot of bleeding going on there.
No.
And not too many veins in a book.
Maybe they could, like, hurt the book. But no one can hurt the book now. Man.
Flair stabbed me, and then I erupted into fire.
Some 13-year-old finding the skin book and carving their name into it. I don't know why that popped up in my head.
Man, Charon carved the maiden's name into the back of the book with, like, a stupid heart.
that sounds... Yeah.
Like a tree.
Man, I can't believe he was going to kill himself, though. That was crazy. That was really crazy.
Oh, yeah. Power of the banker.
The best part. The part about the maiden.
At least it wasn't my fault this time. When Varos and I went to the Ghost River, Margot did, like, really think about killing herself.
What happened?
Charon and Margo have to hang out now.
The VOD is up, I think. I don't think we didn't put up notes for it because it was technically downtime. But the
oh, got you.
Poor Margot. She really has a shit ton of people. Like, she was like, oh yeah, I go around helping people who are like having dark spirits influence them. That's like half the brigade.
Uh-huh. If we survive this campaign, it's just gonna be a bunch of old timers with PTSD. That's all this is gonna be.
Oh, you mean like a normal war? Yeah.
That is how it would be.
Aaron and Angel could do so much damage together.
Don't I know it?
Please, don't leave Key out of the fun.
Colin is absolutely just a fucking drunk that's like, there's 50 different railroads, just fucking go for it, and then fucking passes out. I'll fucking pick a path. You guys fuck up it. I'll fuck.
Colin.
Yeah?
Caleb had a funny idea.
Oh.
What was my funny idea?
What was your funny idea, babe?
I actually don't remember.